Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss graphs of equations and circles. Let's start with an example of sketching the graph of an equation. So the directions say sketch, and in part A, we have 2x plus 4y equals 8. Let's work through this solution. So there's a couple different ways to sketch the graph of an equation like this that's a straight line. One way to do it, which I think is very easy, is to find all the intercepts. Basically, you start by setting each variable equal to 0. So if we set x equal to 0, that's going to give us the y-intercept. Get 2 times 0 plus 4y equals 8. So we have 4y equals 8. Then we can just divide by 4, and that leaves us with y equals 2. So when x is 0, y is 2. So that gives us our first ordered pair. 0, 2. Then you do the same thing with y. You set y equal to 0. And so we have 2x plus 4 times 0 equals 8. So 2x is equal to 8. And then you divide by 2, so you get x equals 4. In this particular case, when x is 4, y is 0. So we have 4, 0. So we have two ordered pairs. We can plot these and connect the dots, and we will have the graph of our line, which is pretty cool. This is a pretty fast method, plus it gives you the intercepts, which is really key. If you use another method, you'll still have to find the intercepts sometimes, so it's just an extra step. This is x. This is y. Let's see, our first ordered pair is 0, 2, so that means you go from the origin, you go right 0 and up 2. I'm going to put two tick marks and put a big blue dot there. That's going to be 0, 2. For the next one, it's 4, 0. So from the origin, we go right 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Put a big dot, and that is our other point. And then you just draw a straight line, or attempt to draw a straight line, connecting the dots, and there you go. There is the equation of the line. So a very powerful method. You could almost do it in your head, right? You have 2x plus 4y equals 8. Write it over here. Let me show you. Watch this. If x is 0, okay, if x is 0, all of this is gone. So you get 4y equals 8, so y equals 2. Boom. Again, if x is 0, this is gone, where the red x is. So 4y is equal to 8. Divide by 4, y equals 2. That gives you the first ordered pair. If y is 0, this is gone, right? Because you get 4 times 0. You get 2x equals 8. So x is 4. So when y is 0, x is 4. When y is 0, x is 4. That gives you the other ordered pair. So you could do it in your head without showing any work. And that's what makes it such a powerful technique. All right, let's do an example of sketching the graph of another type of equation, which is a circle. So here we have the equation of a circle. And you know it's the equation of a circle because you have x squared and you have y squared. Solution. So they're both squared. Let me show you the standard form for a circle. It's this. It's x minus h parentheses squared plus parentheses y minus k, and this whole quantity here is squared, and this is equal to r squared. So this is called the standard form sometimes. Sometimes it's called the center radius form, which I kind of like because here you have the center, which is hk. So this is going to be the center of your circle. And r is going to be the radius of your circle. In our particular case, it's really like x minus 0 squared and y minus 0 squared. So there's no h and k, so they're both 0 and 0. I mean, they are there, they're just 0. So in this case, the center is 0, 0. And r squared is on the right-hand side of the equation for the formula. Here we have a 9. So to find r, you basically take r squared and set it equal to 9. And you solve, and you get a plus or minus, but you only take the plus because it's a radius, it's a distance. So r is 3. So basically, you just take the square root of whatever number you see here. In this case, it's 9, and that's going to give you the radius. All right, so we've got the radius, we've got the center. All that's left is to draw our beautiful circle. So I'm going to start by drawing the y-axis, and we have the x-axis here, so x and y. And so you start from the center. So the center is 0, 0 in this case. So that's where we start from. And so from the center, because it's 0, 0, we go up, down, left, and right by 3. So up, down, left, right. So 1, 2, 3, put a dot. 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 And then you attempt to make a circular object or a circle and just do your best. There we go. That's pretty good. It's pretty good for a freehand circle. And that would be it. That would be the equation, the graph of the equation of the circle. So hopefully after watching this video, you can graph straight lines and you can graph circles, both of which come up a ton in mathematics. This stuff is super useful. If you've enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Until next time, good luck.